NYPD is to continue to make the job better for cops, continue to make the police department better for the community, keep pushing crime down. We also have to always think about counterterrorism. That was something that looms over our heads. My first day as the police commissioner, we had the bombing in Chelsea. But I knew 5 minutes after I heard about it, I knew we were going to bring it to a successful conclusion. And we did that by working together. If I look forward, I'm so honored to have this job. I started in the Bronx a very long time ago. I spent a number of years in this very precinct. I'm not going to mention the number. I wasn't going to say it. But Martín Matarazzo has the best. So I'm going to finish on this note. You know, without trust, and this is what it's all about. It's about trust. We don't move forward. And without love, we have nothing. So thank you very much for inviting me.
Thank you, Commissioner. Please welcome the Commissioner for the Mayor's Community Affairs Unit, the Honorable Marco A. Carrion.
Special service. I want to start off by thanking Reverend Ray Rivera, who has been a strong voice for immigration, for the poor, for the faith community, and for promoting better community police relations throughout this borough, this city, for many years. Just celebrated his 50-year pastor, and the mayor gave an award, the Crystal Apple of the City, which is very rare. So, once again, thank you for having us at your house. This gathering has a special meaning for me as a Latino born and raised in this borough, south of this area. It's always fills me with pride when I can come back and speak in the Bronx, and when the Bronx is together and united as it is in this room. Now more than ever, the mayor's calling on all of us and all agencies to work more closely with New Yorkers, especially given where we are as a nation, where forces seek to divide us. So we are really proud to be able to host this event where NYPD has brought faith communities together with police, with neighborhood groups, to stand side by side. New York City is a beacon for many, a city where diverse communities live together and work hand in hand. We're also the safest big city in the world. This is not possible without police and community working together. Public safety is a priority for all of us. It's a shared concern. And trust between police and community is key to our safety. So the mayor is committed to building relationships and repairing trust where it's been broken. And we look to faith communities to help us build unity and understanding. As they say, to build bridges and not walls. And to meet the challenges with perseverance and hope. So I'll end with a quote from one of the greatest faith leaders of our time, who passed through the divided nation. Bishop Desmond Tutu said, "Hope is being able to see that there is light despite all the darkness." So I want to thank all of our faith leaders and community leaders for helping us to create more hope when we need it the most, and for the NYPD for keeping us safe. I'm going to take a point of personal privilege now and invite out our public safety chair and your council member, Vanessa Gibson.
Good evening, everyone.
Hello.
Good evening, Bronx.
Hey.
You look good. I am so thankful to be here. I welcome you to LPAC. I welcome you to the 4-4 precinct, to our home. I thank you to Reverend Dr. Raymond Rivera and the LPAC family. I want to recognize my good friend, Bervin Harris, the executive director of Renaissance Youth Center. Those talented young people, thank you, Bervin. I want to recognize all of our wonderful and distinguished members of the clergy, to the NYPD, to my friend and our commissioner, Jimmy O'Neill and his team, to Chief Joanne Jaffe, to Patrol Borough Bronx, Chief McCullion, Chief Pinto, Chief McCarthy. So I love to do this because we are in God's country, as the Bronx Borough President has said. So I want to take a point of privilege and thank our Mayor Bill de Blasio and his team, and Commissioner Marco Carrion and the Community Affairs Unit, and to everyone joined here today. To God be the glory. Yes, we look good. And we are fired up because we know we have a lot of work to do. So when I begin in the house of God, I always say that I give honor to God, who is the head of my life. He gives me strength, motivation, encouragement. He wakes me up every single day to fulfill his destiny for my life. And I am thankful for that. I want to thank all of our NYPD family because we are family. Whether you represent the 4-0, the 4-1, the 4-2, the 4-3, the 4-4, 4-5, 4-6, 4-7, 4-8, 4-9, 5-0, 5-2, PSA 7, PSA 8, not done, Transit District 11 and Transit District 12. To all of our phenomenal community affairs officers and detectives. These are the officers that we call upon whenever we need something to get done. Day or night, they answer our calls, and they always respond when they're called upon. I also want to thank our NCO officers who do phenomenal work. We also work so closely with them. This interfaith service tonight, and I am so grateful that we're here at LPAC. We're here in the borough of the Bronx because we continue to recognize that we are all stakeholders in the common goal of providing public safety for every New Yorker. Regardless of your neighborhood, your background, your status, your ethnicity, none of that matters because we are all children of God. And in his eyes, we all look the same. And so I want to make sure that everyone is reminded, and you've heard from all of our wonderful clergy members, no matter your religion, we come together on so many issues of common ground, like education, public safety, jobs, economic development, quality health care, services for children and seniors. That is the fabric of our communities, and we are getting things done. As a borough, we are moving in the right direction. We're recognizing that we can no longer stand on the sidelines and be a part of the problem, but yet be a part of the solution. So I thank all of you for recognizing the role that you play, all of the elected officials, community board members, precinct council presidents, and executive board members. You simply do not need a title in front of your name to do any of this work. You don't need to be a council member, a commissioner, a chief, a bishop, a father. It doesn't matter, ladies and gentlemen. All you need is passion for your brothers and sisters. We are each other's brothers and sisters' keepers. We say it, but we need to make sure that we mean it and we live a lifestyle that practices it. Mm-hmm. God gives us purpose every day. He doesn't have to wake us up, but you know what? He does anyway. And he gives us that purpose. We can do nothing in this work without a plan. And so I want everyone to understand, as we leave here tonight, we need to be re-energized and recommitted like never before. Because our children call for it. They need the love, the attention. They need the guidance. They need the nurturing. We need to make sure that as we walk out these doors, we always remember that we walk by faith and not sight. We say it and we mean it. And so I thank all of you. I am just so grateful. You are my family. You have allowed me for 3 years to be your council member. And I say to you, thank you. Thank God for all of you for not only walking with me and working with me, but praying with me. Because we know that prayer has the ability to change people and situations. Look at what God can do. And I'm not afraid as an elected official to talk about how good God has been to me. I will never be afraid to talk about the work that God has allowed all of us to do. And so I thank all of you, and I thank this administration, this NYPD, these faith-based leaders, because we get it. And we are seeing the results as a result of our work and our labor. And so I thank all of you for coming out tonight. It's great to see all of you. You guys know I am someone that works each and every day. And not only is my office literally around the corner, but I do make sure that the residents of District 16 see the work that we're doing. Because there are a lot of non-believers out there that don't see the work that we're doing. And so we need all of you to be the ambassadors, the change agents, the soldiers, the warriors that are out there fighting the good fight. Do not allow anyone to take you off course or cause you to lose focus on what is important. Our next generation of leaders. And so I wish all of you Godspeed, God's continued guidance, and certainly prayers of strength so that we can continue to do the work that we have all been called to do. Thank you for allowing me a chance to greet you. I look forward to working with each and every one of you, and I just want to make sure I recognize everybody, which I did, and I just want to make sure that I have a chance to acknowledge the anti-gun violence and cure violence workers that do incredible work. Thank you for being our partners. Thank you for all the work that you have done. God bless you all, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Gibson. I would now like to reintroduce Pastor Raymond Rivera for a closing reflection.
I'd like to thank everyone for being here. We've already had a miracle of faith service, and it's only a little over an hour. So I want to say that as I close with this reflection, we're all living in the shadow of the recent presidential election.
No.
And it certainly
just
has
not
had
the place.
An impact on all of us. And there's such diversity of opinion and diversity of ideology related to this time that we're living in, to this president that has been elected. There are some that feel that it's the fulfillment of biblical prophecy and that we're moving toward Armageddon, or the mother of all wars. There are others that feel that he is God's instrument and he's going to make America great again. Mm-hmm. And he's going to restore America to its previous Christian values. And there are others that feel that he's a racist, sexist, anti-immigrant, womanizing narcissist. But regardless of what your opinion is, or what your political persuasion is, our trust wasn't in President Obama. Our trust is not in President Trump. Our trust is in the Lord. If you believe that, give the Lord a hand for it. And repeat with me for this ending benediction. It's from the psalmist, and I want you to line the verse with me. That's an old African slave tradition. Slaves wasn't allowed to read. Usually the pastor was the only one that knew how to read. And in the black slave tradition, he used to line the verse, which means he would say something and the people would repeat it. So I want you to repeat with me, bless the Lord,
bless the Lord,
all my soul,
all my soul,
and all that is within me. Bless his holy name.
Bless his holy name.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
All my soul.
All my soul.
And forget not his benefits.
Let's
bow our heads. Lord, we bless this assembly, men. This assembly, we bless particularly all of the police officers. We bless them in a special way. We ask for guidance, direction. Those decisions that they have to make, that sometimes they have to make it within seconds. They probably fear those decisions every day as they walk out of their homes. We pray for stability for them, Lord. Oh, Lord, we pray for, Lord, that you just may be able to protect them, that they may get back home, Lord, in a safe way every day. We pray, Lord, for our community, the tension, the conflict, the lack of trust. We pray for those incidences, Lord, that have caused division and polarization in our communities. We pray for the mothers of the movement that have lost children, Lord, and they feel alienated from law enforcement. We pray for the spirit of reconciliation, Lord. We pray that you may bring us together. We don't want to romanticize the situation. We know that there's tension, Lord. Help us manage the tension. Give guidance. The man that you put at the head of this, Commissioner O'Neill, give him wisdom as he tries to manage all of these tensions and conflicts and turmoils, that the city may continue to be a testimony to the nation at the time when there's so much polarization all over the nation, that they may look to the city of New York for models, that they may see us as an example. Give us a spirit of humility, Lord, that we may do this, Lord, for your glory, for your honor. As a faith community, we lift up your name. Everyone say, we lift up your name.
We lift up your name.
We give you the glory and the honor, and we ask this in the name of our Savior. Amen. 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 And greet somebody, turn around and greet somebody.
Thank you, Pastor. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our program. On behalf of the Police Commissioner and the Commissioner for the Mayor's Community Foundation, I'd like to thank you for attending our program. Please join us for refreshments in the room right across the hallway. Have a pleasant evening and a safe home. Thank you.